Guys, guys, shot.
Lahuna Random is first.
No.
Beautiful is first. I did not get that.
Don't you.
Oh. Good to know.
Shabbat Shalom, Rabbi Nanus. Shabbat Shalom. Carol, Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, everyone. Welcome to this special Shabbat of special music in honor of the 80th birthday, next Wednesday, of the great Carole King. Welcome. You've got to get up every morning with a smile on your face and show the world all the love in your heart. Treat you better, you're gonna find, yes you will, that you're beautiful as you feel. Waiting at the station with a workday window blowing, I've got nothing to do but watch the passers-by. Mirrored in their faces I see frustration growing, and they don't see it showing. Why do I? Smile on your face, show the world all the love in your heart. People gonna treat you better, you're gonna find your swill, that you're beautiful as you feel. Myself the reason for the sadness in the world, where tears are just a lullaby. If there's any answer, maybe love can end the madness, maybe not, but we can only try. You've got to get up every morning with a smile on your face and show the world all the love in your heart. The people are gonna treat you better, you're gonna find, yes, you will, that you're beautiful. You're beautiful. You're beautiful as you feel.
Shabbat Shalom, everyone. It's so nice to be with you tonight with Cantor Gurney and Cantor Kerith Spencer-Shapiro. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, Rabbi.
So Carole King, we all grew up on Carole King's music, and her name actually is Carole King Klein, and she is considered one of the most influential musicians of the 20th century and the most successful songwriter, woman songwriter of the second half of the 20th century. She had 25 solo albums and 118 pop hits, and she's won all kinds of musical awards, and we are singing her music and celebrating her music tonight, but really she's just one in a huge tradition of Jewish music from the very beginning of the Torah. We've had musicians all along. Music is part of our Jewish DNA, and here's a song that's in our DNA, a Shabbat song that we're going to begin with for this service, Lechu Naranana.
Lechunerana, lechunerana, latonai. Lechunerana, 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 latonai. Naria, naria, letzuni shenu, lekadema fana betoda. Naria, naria, letzuni shenu. Is mirot daria la lechunerana 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 adonai lechunerana 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 adonai naria naria letzu yishenu ekadama fana metoda Nariya, Nariya, Etsuyishenu, Bizmirot Dariyolo, Lechuneranena, 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 Adonai, Lechuneranena, 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 Adonai.
We enter into the Shabbat, what I call the zone of Shabbat, with our candle lighting, which just propels us into a whole new atmosphere of peace and family and harmony. So if you at home would like to join us as we light the Shabbat candles, please do so now.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kidashanu B'mitzvotav V'tzivanu Le'adlik ner
Let's all join together in Kiddush. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei peri hagafen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'ratzavanu v'shabbat kodsho Be'ahava uvratzon hinchilanu Zikaron lemaaseh v'reishit Ki hu yom techilah Le'mikra'e kodesh Zecher yitziat Mitzrayim Kivanu v'achata Otanu kidashta mikol hamim v'shabbat kodshecha be'ahava uveratzon hinchaltanu baruch atah Adonai Mekaresh HaShabbat.
Amen.
L'chaim.
L'chaim.
Motzi together. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Amotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen.
We've lit the candles to create the aura of Shabbat. We've blessed the wine. We've tasted the delicious challah. We're ready to let in the Shabbat bride with Lecha Dodi.
Lecha Dodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha Dodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Shamor v'zachor v'diburecha Hishmi'anu el ha-miyuchad Adonai echad u'shamo echad V'shem u'tver
Shemet v'lite hila.
Rosh mikadam nesucha sof maase b'machshava tchila lecha dodi lecha dodi lecha kala b'nishavat nekala lecha dodi lecha kala b'nishavat nekala
hit ore Torri, kiva orei, kumi ori, 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 shir da meri, kvoda da na ya lech ni gela, lecha,
dodi, dodi, lecha, dodi, lecha, kala, benishabat nekala,
lecha, dodi, lecha, kala,
We face our doors and welcome the Shabbat bride into our midst.
Bo'i v'shalom ateret ba'ala gam b'simcha u'v'tzor toch
As you know, Lecha Dodi was written by Shlomo Alkabetz, a Kabbalist in the city of Tzvat. And the tradition in Tzvat was to go out into the fields to welcome the Shabbat bride. But I think you could welcome the Shabbat bride anywhere, even up on the roof.
trouble brews. So if this world starts getting you down, there's room enough for two up on the roof. Up on the roof, everything is all right. Up on the roof, up on the roof, up on the roof, up on the roof.
Continue with the Baruch Hu. If you would like to, please rise. The Jewish tradition and our Jewish Tanakh, our Bible, is filled with love songs. There's an entire book of love songs, Shir HaShirim, where we have Ani LeDodi VeDodi Li, Dodi Li VeAni Lo, beautiful love songs. And our prayers, which were originally poems, and they're called Piyutim, were also filled with love songs, and one of them is something we sing every Erev Shabbat, every Friday night, Ahavat Olam.
Tanurim Marta Ark ismach b'nitmach toratecha Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Baruch Shem, Kvod Malchuto, Leolam
We join together now. Ve'ahavta.
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha b'chol levavcha u'v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'odecha ve'hayu ha'devarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha Hayom al levavecha, v'shinantam levanecha, v'dibarta bam, v'shivtecha bevetecha, uvelechtecha vaderech, uveshochpecha uvkumecha, ukshartam leot al yadecha, v'hayu letotafot ben enecha. Uchtavtam al mezuzot betecha uvishkarecha Lema'an tizkeruhu va'asitem et kol mitzvotai Vihitem kedoshim le'elohechem Ani Adonai Elohechem Asher hotzeti erchem me'eretz mitzrayim Lihiyot lachem l'Elohim, ani Adonai Elohechem.
So I pointed out that Ahavat Olam starts with the word Ahava, which means love, and the V'ahavta also has Ahava in it, meaning you shall love. Love is so important, whether we're reading it or singing it, and just to remind us of what the V'ahavta says, I'm going to read the translation this evening. You shall love Adonai your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. Take to heart these instructions which I charge you this day. Impress them upon your children. Recite them when you stay at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you get up. Bind them as a sign on your hand and let them serve as a symbol on your forehead. Inscribe them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. Thus you shall remember to observe all of my mitzvot, my commandments, and to be holy to your God. I am Adonai your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God. I am Adonai your God. There's a beautiful midrash that when the Israelites crossed the sea, as we know, they sang to God. There's a midrash that when God heard this music, this singing, this shir, this song, which is a very important part of our liturgy and our Torah, God reflected when Abraham, and I saved Isaac from Abraham. He didn't sing to me. When I gave Isaac Rebecca, I helped him fall in love. He didn't sing to me. When the angel wrestled with Jacob and gave him the name Israel, he didn't sing to me. Even when Joseph was redeemed from the prison, he didn't sing to me. But my children of Israel on the shore, they're singing to me. And this is what I have been waiting for. This is the Micha Mocha.
Chazak mimenu Baruch ata Adonai Ga'al Yisrael.
Traditionally, the Hashkivenu prayer is said before you go to sleep, but we say it in the evening so that we can all chant it together. It's an ancient prayer, but it's words seem more relevant today than in most of my life. I think I took it for granted, but in the last couple of years, they resonate so strongly. I'm going to read them to you. Grant us, O God, that we lie down in peace and raise us up our guardian to life renewed. Spread over us the sukkah of your peace. Guide us with your good counsel for your name's sake. Be our help. Shield us and shelter us beneath the shadow of your wings. Defend us against enemies, illness, war, famine, and sorrow. Distance us from wrongdoing. For you, God, watch over us and deliver us. For you, God, are gracious and merciful. Guard our going and coming to life and peace evermore. Hashkivenu.
Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu l'shalom, l'shalom, v'ha'amidenu sarkenu, l'shalom.
Sages say that you don't really pray, or prayer is not really a prayer unless you speak from your heart, unless you have something personal that you pray for. The Hasidim say that God listens to every word, and God cares about everything down to the smallest blade of grass. The Kabbalists say that when you pray for something good, for goodness, you release divine and holy sparks into the world. So now we're going to take a few moments for you to release beautiful sparks, to connect with God, to speak from your heart for our silent Amina, a time of personal meditation and prayer.
Shalom Rav Yisrael Amcha.
So if Carole King is the secular Jewish most successful woman singer-songwriter, Cantors, I wonder if you would agree that our own Jewish Carole King would be Debbie Friedman, who changed the sound of liturgy for all of us and inspired many other songwriters, cantors, and musicians to feel free to also create new Jewish music, but she really changed everything. I actually saw an amazing documentary about Jews in Ghana, and they were singing the Debbie Friedman Oseh Shalom in Ghana.
Even better is when you go to an Orthodox service and they're singing Debbie Friedman.
That is better.
If so they only knew.
Exactly. They do know. She's amazing. And I believe we're going to be singing her Mishavera.
We are.
But now is the time for us to take a moment to remember those in our lives who need blessings of healing. I want to mention Kayla Schwartz, Charles Schwartz, and Alan Cerotti for special blessings. Their families have asked us to mention them, and we are thinking of you. And anyone else in your life who needs healing, say their names out loud right now as we sing Debbie Friedman's Mishaverach. Blessings of healing to all of you, and we want you to know from Wilshire Boulevard Temple, you've got a friend. Going right.
don't you let them.
You just call my name.
And you know wherever I am, I'll come running. Oh, yes, I will.
To see you again. To see you again.
Winter, spring, summer, or fall.
Winter, spring, summer, or fall.
All you gotta do is call.
Is call.
And I'll be there. Yes, I will.
You've got a friend.
Just a few announcements before we continue. I want to just let everybody know that we've resumed our More European Jewish Journeys with Mike Hollander every Tuesday morning from 9:30 to 10:45 on Zoom. He's an amazing teacher and travel guide, and he is taking us each week to another European country and telling us the history of Jews there. Last week we did Budapest City, and we're going to Vienna this Tuesday. Also on Wednesday, there's a wonderful program happening at 7:45 Wednesday night called Jewish Genes, What It Means, and it's about hereditary cancer in the Jewish community, and it's all the information about the latest genetic testing. We have experts, doctors, cancer thriver to speak about her experience, and we hope you'll join us. And I just want to mention what's all, it's on our minds, how Amnesty International this week accused Israel of fomenting apartheid and the lies and the falsehoods that they are saying about Israel. And the American Jewish Committee has put out an amazing statement. And we urge you to take a look online at the AJC.org, what they've said, and to let you know that in the coming weeks and months, we will be having some very deep and interesting programs about anti-Semitism, and we hope that you will join us when that happens. So now I want to talk a little bit about Jewish music, because the tradition of Jewish music is a lot older than even I thought. Of course, the Cantors knew about this because they studied music for 5 years. Because why? Because you're that old? They're so old. That's what Cantor Gurney just said. But the first musician is mentioned in the fourth chapter of the book of Genesis in Bereshit. In the fourth chapter, at the very beginning of our whole history, his name was Yuval, and they say that he was the father of all who played string instruments and pipes. And it's in a list of accomplishments of humanity with the use of copper and iron and the breeding of cattle. It was on the same level. And so the Torah is saying the creation of music is a core part of civilization. So he was the first musician. And we could say that he lived 4,000 years ago, if we're going, at least 4,000 years ago. Then we have the first singer and musician, I guess a role model for Carole King. It was Miriam, Moses' and Aaron's sister, because it says in the Torah, then Miriam the prophetess, the sister of Aaron, took a tambourine in her hand, and all the women went out after her with tambourines and dancing, and she sang. Miriam sang, sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea. And some scholars believe Miriam wrote the whole Shirat Hayam, that she wrote the entire Song of the Sea. So she is our first singer and musician, because she was playing the tambourine. Then we have our first biblical Jewish singer-songwriting team. This is in the book of Deborah, which would have been about 1100 BCE. And after a huge military victory, Barak, who was the leader. He asked Deborah to go with him to inspire them. She was a prophetess and a judge, and they defeated the Canaanites. And it says, on that day, Deborah and Barak, the son of Ahinoam, sang, "Hear, O kings, give ear, O potentates. I will sing. We will sing to the Lord. We'll hymn the Lord, the God of Israel." And then we have probably the most prolific. He was a musician, a composer, a singer, a songwriter. He kind of invented music therapy, we could say, which was King David. David, he played music, he wrote the Psalms, he sang beautifully. He sang to King and played for King Saul, who had mental issues. As it is told in the Torah, he was agitated, and only David's music could soothe him. And later, when he was king, he actually commissioned a huge orchestra of Levites and songwriters. So he was also an impresario of music. So David is, and he lived about 1000 BCE. So you can see that's a very long tradition of music. As time went on, different Jewish music evolved. One thing actually was being chanting. Chanting the Torah, chanting the Tanakh, the whole thing helped people learn and remember. And so song and melody and tune helped people learn, and they soon were able to chant together. Then piyutim, hymns, were introduced into the liturgy, and a kind of hymns again where there could be group singing. This tradition actually also existed in Spain, where they then created folk songs. And the Ladino composers were influenced by Arab and Spanish poetry as well. I want to mention one very famous Sephardic composer. I know the Cantors know about Salomone Rossi, who was the court composer, Jewish man, of the Duke of Mantua in the 1600s. But did you know about his sister, Europa Rossi, known as Madama Europa, who was the first Jewish woman to be a professional opera singer, and she was also hired by the Duke, and she sang, and I love that she was Madame Europa, and she was very glamorous and beautiful and had a gorgeous voice. During the 16th century, while that was going on in Italy and wherever the Sephardim had emigrated to, this is also when the Kabbalists started to use music as well in their, they wrote Lachadodi, for example, and other beautiful prayers. And there was this sense that music elevated your soul. Suddenly music was just not something to feel good and to uplift you, but it actually literally elevated your soul. And this went into the Hasidic world as well in the 18th century, where then we know we have the Nigun, which is the wordless tune, the Yai-Dai-Dai, which also the Hasidim believed was the highest level of singing, right, Cantors? The highest level was wordless with no words, and also elevated your soul and helped you ascend to what they called a higher level of mystical enthusiasm. Of course, finally came the Haskalah, the emancipation, when Jews were not, you know, limited to just their own society, when they were able to go to university, to mingle with everybody else, and that's when music exploded. So we have Felix Mendelssohn. Even though he converted, he was still considered a Jew, but I don't know if you know that his sister Fanny Mendelssohn was also a composer. And we have Mahler and Schoenberg and Aaron Copland and Irving Berlin, and then it goes all the way into America in the 20th century, Bernstein, Sondheim, on Broadway, all of our amazing composers. But who I want to mention in particular were the musicians in Terezin and Theresienstadt. So Theresienstadt, as we know, was a concentration camp. It was 15 miles outside of Prague, and the Jews who went there were mainly from four cities: Berlin, Prague, Frankfurt, and Vienna. And who were these Jews? They were cultured, cultivated, and many of them were musicians. And they were told they could only bring 60 kilos of property with them, and that was not a lot, and they all brought their instruments. They brought their instruments. And when they got there, they created orchestras and cabarets and operas. And I just want to mention some of their names because we should remember them. Victor Ullmann. The Nazis gave him an assignment telling him to compose and organize concerts there, which he did. And Hans Krause, who wrote the children's opera Brundibar, which was composed by the performed by the children, and it was really, even though the Nazis didn't know it, an allegory about what Hitler was doing. And Gideon Klein, who was a composer and played piano, and he continued writing all kinds of music, and Pavel Haas, who was a jazz musician. Music is part of Jewish life, of Jewish consciousness, of Jewish sensibility. Carole King is just an example. You know, she inherited this legacy. And I just want to mention another woman that I never heard about, maybe you have, named Debbie Wiseman. Debbie Wiseman is in England, and she is considered the most romantic and lyrical composer alive in Europe today, Jewish. She's the most prolific, and she's written 200 scores for film and television in the last 20 years, and she was made a dame. She got an honor for her music. And she's very strongly identified as a Jewish woman. So what can we say about all of this music? It has many strains and comes from many sources. I guess you would call it a tapestry.
Some uncertainty, as if he didn't know just what he was there for or where he ought to go. Once he reached for something golden hanging from a tree, and his hand came down empty. Tapestry along the rutted road. He sat down on a river rock and turned into a toad. It seemed that he had fallen into someone's wicked spell, and I wept to see him suffer, though I didn't know him well. As I watch in sorrow, there suddenly appeared a figure gray and ghostly beneath a flowing beard. In hues of deepest darkness, I've seen him dressed in black. Now my tapestry's unraveling. He's come to take me back. He's come to take me back.
take a moment now to remember those who are no longer with us, those who have passed away, as we prepare to say our Kaddish prayer. We begin with those who passed away during this last month, during Shloshim, as we remember Steve Asrakan, Susan Brody, Daniel Dworsky, Elaine Edelstein, Beverly Feinstein, Robert Joseph Flicker, Richard Bernard Halligan, John Harris, Annette Henkin-Landau, Alexandra Lauterbach, Stephen Leventhal, Anita Marston, Yvette Mimieux, Janice Sarnoff, Bella Schimmel-Desser, Soon-Li Sung, Marvin Jack Teitelbaum, Ruth Tober, Steve Tolkien, and Iraj Eliyahu Yadid Sion. We also remember those whose yahrzeits occurred during this past week, the anniversaries of their deaths. We remember Eliana Burlfein, Mary Berman, Benjamin Blum, David Blumenstein, Sorrel Brook, Paul Brock, Anita Brody, Deborah Bronner, Herman Berg, Henry Kleinick Kahn, Ruth Kaplan, Richard Channon, Michael Chesler, David Cohn, Joel Curry, Gladys Davis, Harold Donzis, Frida Doro, Robert Ehrman, Sheila Feldman, Sidney Fell, Hildy Ann Fell, Anne Glansrock, Esther Goldberg, Eva Golden, Edward Goldfeder, Herbert Goldinger, Samuel Goodman, Belle Gordon, Lorianne Gordon, William Green, Evelyn Guggenheim, Edith Guggenheim, Ezat Hamlimi, Samuel Warner Halper, Elizabeth Hartfield, Eugene Holden, Boaz Hopenstand, Willie Jacobson, Elizabeth Jane Kahani, Marvin Kalin, Vicky Carcomi, Bruno Katz, Melvin Kaimak, Jeremiah Kerner, Natalie Kaiser, Mayor Ben Natan Kakshuri, Edie Kirshner, Herbert Klin, Molly Lou Kolpas, Ronald Canovi, Cleo Koppelson, Jacob Koppel, Sam Kapalski, Jessica Korn, Faye Davidoff Cosberg, Bernard Krakow, Rosa Kren, Chaim Kurtzman, Geraldine Lapidus, Emma Lena, Arthur Levin, Zelda Melikowski, Nathan Marblestone, Steve Menkes, Joel Miller, Lillian Miller, Edward Mitchell, Naomi Moyer, Michael Nash, Looney Oster, Thea Persoff, Francine Peterman, Stephen Platt, Judas Polger, Bolick Rayner, Shirley Ribicoff, William Richman, Nate Rosenberg, Alice Rosenzweig, Fred Rosenoff, Yuel Roston, Lillian Roth, Gerald Rubin, Frida Sachs, Alan Seldinger, Marlene Sauer, Morris Savin, Mark Steven Schwarz, Rose Siegel, Lillian Sinitsky, Neville Shear, Abraham Shevitz, Ann Schrager, Ephraim Silber, Kenny Singer, Bruce Stein, Leon Julius Steinsapper, Alice Sugarman, Boyd Sweet, Morris Tarika, Jerome Tober, Erna Viterbi, Dina Waller, Evelyn Wasserman, Joseph Wexler, Ida Weisblatt, Ida Wiseman, Sam Weitz, Ronald Frank Whippern, Irvin Wixon, Ruth Ziegler. We also remember those who gave their lives defending the United States of America and the State of Israel, and those who died in senseless violence, terrorism, illness. We also remember those who have no one to say Kaddish for them. We take them all as our own. As we turn to read the Kaddish, if you would like to rise, if you are able to, please do so now. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shemei rabah, v'yalma divra chirute v'yamlich machute, v'chayechon v'yomechon v'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael, v'agala v'zman kari v'imru, amen. Yehe shmei rabah mevarach le'olam olmei olmaya, yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitbar v'yitromam v'yitnaseh, V'yit hadar, v'yit haleh, v'yit halal, shmei d'kudasha b'richu. Ve'elamin kol birchata v'shirata, tushbachata v'nechamata, dam yiram v'yoma v'imru, amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya, v'chayim aleinu v'yal kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. Oseh shalom v'imromav, hu yaseh shalom, aleinu v'yal kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. Our cantors for such a beautiful evening of music. Thank you,
Rabbi Nanus.
Thank you, Rabbi Nanus, as well for all of your beautiful commentary and insights, and to our wonderful musicians, Bill Beck at the piano, Jonathan Pintoff on bass, Hope Easton on cello, and Leo Shalyapov on clarinet and saxophone, flute, and anything else that you can blow into.
Shalom bim Roma, hu yaseh shalom aleinu. Shalom bim Roma, hu yaseh shalom aleinu. Ose shalom bim Roma, hu yaseh shalom aleinu. Yaseh shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom.